So this phone has a 6.43 inch AMOLED display with a refresh rate of 90Hz and of course a max brightness of 1000 nits. You get 256GB of internal memory and 8GB of RAM. You do have a headphone jack. You do of course have micro SD support as well. You get a 33W charger included. So when you look at those things, you're probably like, what are you paying for those specifications? What are you paying for the basics that come with the phone as well? Well, what if I told you that it was the Poco M4 Pro? Would you believe me? Because that's what you get with the Poco M4 Pro. So let's discuss the Poco M4 Pro in this full review of the device. Because honestly, there's a lot to like about the device and there are some things to note as well. Either way, let's jump into the full review of the Poco M4 Pro. So the Poco M4 Pro, let's quickly run through the basics. So these are the specifications for the Poco M4 Pro. It has a 6.43 inch AMOLED display with a 90Hz refresh rate and of course a max brightness of 1000 nits. My version has 256GB of UFS 2.2 storage and of course you get 8GB of RAM. The CPU is a MediaTek Helio G96. The main camera is a 64 megapixel sensor and the ultrawide is an 8 megapixel sensor. You do have an additional third camera that is a 2 megapixel sensor and it's a macro, however I don't care for that one. Max video recording is 1080p and 30 frames per second. This also is the case for the front camera that is a 16 megapixel sensor. It has micro SD support and of course a 3.5mm headphone jack. And the battery is a 5000mAh battery that you can charge with the 33W charger that comes included with the phone itself. And of course the fingerprint scanner is a side-mounted fingerprint scanner. The Poco M4 Pro, I think one of the best things about it is honestly the display. The display is really solid. It's an AMOLED display and I think that's already a great step compared to of course their previous generation. And it's not just the basic one. The Poco M4 Pro has a display that can go up to max brightness of 1000 nits and you can definitely tell. I was comparing this phone with some other Motorola's and the brightness was definitely a lot better on the Poco M4 Pro. That allowed me to take better shots outside to showcase what it can do and of course have a better composition because I can better see what is going on the display itself. That is one of the biggest benefits for me, especially when it's sunny outside, you get that sun going on your display, the brightness helps a lot. Therefore, I would say the display with combined of course the colors that it has and of course the deeper blacks allows this display to perform well. And I think this is one of the biggest things about the device. Then of course we come to camera and then we have that main 64 megapixel sensor. So how is it from day to day? There are some things that I've noticed. Overall, I think it's fine, but there are some things that I've noticed. For my own liking, sometimes I think it oversharpens a little bit too much. It can make bricks, for instance, in houses stand out a little bit too much, where it is in general a little bit softer and it doesn't stand out as it is on images that you get from the Poco M4 Pro. But overall, I will have to say that the camera is actually quite capable. It can capture some really good shots and depending on the shot itself and the composition, that sharpening can definitely help. And for instance, in a case of shooting that church that I have here in the city, it definitely does help to have that little bit of sharpening going on the phone itself. So therefore, I would say when it comes to the camera and the main sensor, it is actually really capable. You of course do have an 8 megapixel ultrawide and what I can tell is that of course it doesn't come with the same quality and I think it's a bit of a shame but understandable. Of course we are not talking about a high-end phone here, but you can definitely tell that the main sensor is far more capable than of course the ultrawide. The 2 megapixel one we're not even going to discuss. When it comes to video recording, sadly it is limited to 1080p and 30 frames per second. This again counts also for the front facing camera. But what I think is the main reason is that they wanted to make sure that every single lens captures at the same FPS and of course the same resolution. But at the end what matters more is of course the quality of pixels compared to the quantity of it. Either way, here are some samples with video recording and a little bit more of images as well. then of course we have battery life. Now, the Poco M4 Pro has a 5000 milliampere hour battery inside. This often lasts me to the end of the day. If I use it a little bit more, so light heavy use, that makes sense, I get about 20% left at the end of the day. If I use it a bit more average, I get about, let's say, 30 to 35% left in battery life. So battery life here is solid and I really don't have any issues here when it comes to that performance. If you do want to charge it, as stated, you do get that 33 watt included with the phone itself, and it takes about an hour to charge the phone up. So not too fast, but honestly, 33 watt, that's perfectly fine for a phone around this budget. So that's basically the battery life performance. Now, Poco of course also wants MIUI. Now, this without a doubt is not the lightest game that you can get on an Android device. And you can tell with a lot of devices that run MIUI, it isn't the smoothest or anything like that. It works well, I don't really have any issues on the Poco M4 Pro, but it definitely isn't the fastest system out there. And you can definitely tell in day-to-day use that compared to something where it's a flagship, for instance, that runs MIUI, you can tell it performs better, or some other software skins that just perform better as well. I can tell that there is a difference. For instance, a Motorola device that I've tested, yeah, the software is lighter and therefore it is a little bit more smoother and it runs through things a little bit faster. Sometimes it's just a little bit doubting about whether they want to go to that setting or something like that. So it can take a little bit longer to do certain steps. Again, not long, just that fraction where you can tell there's a difference in terms of the skin itself and where it performs. What I really do like though, when it comes to, of course, having MIUI, is that you do get a gallery app. Not all phones actually offer that. A lot of phones sadly offer you Google Images, I think it is. I hate that, I don't like it. And if I just want to use and see my images, I'd rather have a separate gallery app where I can check out what I've taken on the phone itself instead of seeing from other phones as well. Either way, I think the gallery app is definitely one of the things that I really like about it. And of course, having an app drawer as well. Overall, the Poco M4 Pro performs well. And in terms of audio, it's actually quite decent as well. Of course, you are talking about a phone that is far lower in cost than some others. And you can tell with audio experience as well. For instance, the front one does sound a little bit muffled compared to some other ones that are far higher in price. But honestly, it's not bad either. And you don't notice that in call quality is actually quite solid here as well. And of course, the side-mounted fingerprint scanner is fast, and I actually think it's slightly faster than, for instance, on the Poco X4 Pro 5G that I have. So, is the Poco M4 Pro worth it? Well, yes. You get a lot in the package when it comes to the device itself. You get that 33-watt charger, you get that great display, and of course, you do get a pretty good camera setup for the price as well. Of course, like I said, it can sharpen things up a little bit too much for my taste, but again, I do think overall the camera is actually quite solid for the price. Either way, what do you think about the Poco M4 Pro? Do you like it? Do you love it? Or don't you like it? And what don't you like about it? Or what do you like about it? Let me know in the comments below. And isn't it funny how phones like this offer so much more than a lot of flagships these days? Just basic stuff. Either way, hope you enjoyed this review. And of course, if you did, don't forget to hit a like, subscribe, and do all that stuff. And of course, talk to you guys in the next. Yeah.